March 24th, 2002. A group of us, five women and three men, set out to distant Peru, almost 10,000 kilometers away from us. Being farmers, most of us are sitting on an aeroplane for the first time in our life. All through our long journey, we are tingling with anticipation of what awaits us in a distant and alien land. What can we give and what can we take back with us? The first thing that envelops us in Peru is music. As soon as we land, we are welcomed by a group of indigenous musicians. The same musical welcome follows us everywhere we go among the Quechua community in Cuyo Grande. When we add our own music into this Quechua music, the blend between cultures becomes perfect. We present the Quechua community with a textile painted with vegetable dyes and pots of seeds from the Deccan, two symbols of our culture. The music never stops from then on. We move into the villages and cities which had left behind the magnificent trails of the Inca civilization. Our visit to Machu Picchu was a lifetime experience for us, reflecting a past that combined all the knowledge and ingenuity of humankind. The Machu Picchu structures leave us speechless. The magnificent Andes, which hosted the Machu Picchu civilization, still continues to cradle the same creativity as we evidenced in the food and farming cultures of the Quechua people. We witness the magical flora and fauna which the potato park communities have so lovingly nurtured and retained. The amazing diversity of their crops and their animals blow our mind. As we see how to cultivate this extraordinary diversity, the Quechua community has worked this rugged terrain with their bare hands, our minds go back to the rugged plains of the Deccan and our own farming systems. In the Deccan, for centuries, farmers have used animals as partners in their agriculture. The magnificent bullocks of the Deccan plow our harsh lands and soften them up to receive the seeds. Exactly like the Quechua communities, our communities also sow a diverse variety of seeds. Women play a key role in nurturing this diversity. Complex seed drills called gurru are used to plant the seeds. In our farming practice, women ensure that a variety of seeds are planted to bring up diverse crops. The resultant biodiversity on the Deccan farms offers a bewildering sight. Tens of varieties of millets, sorghum, pulses, oil seeds jostle side by side for their own space on the farm. All through the cropping season, women are constantly engaged in farming operations. They weed the land, they harvest the crops, and they are major players in threshing operations. When the crops come home, it is the women who store them through their own ingenious methods. This continuous interaction with seeds, crops, and the earth and her bounties leads to a relationship that transcends simple production. It turns spiritual. We in the Deccan address land as Bhootalli, the Mother Earth. We worship her and other elements in nature such as animals, water and spirits in various forms. Each of this worship surrounded by endless celebration and spirituality. We are delighted to see that in Peru, the earth is called Pachamama, the Mother Earth, just the way we do. When the shaman performs the Pachamama worship, using cocoa leaves, beads, seeds, rocks and other elements, calling all the mountains and waters to accept his offering, the spirituality that he evokes irrevocably binds us with the Andean community. The same sense of spirituality follows us when we visit the potato park and witness for ourselves the amazing range of potatoes grown on these heights. In colors ranging from blue to red and in a variety of shapes and sizes, the potatoes give us a glimpse of the fantastic diversity that nature and man are capable of producing. We find a very similar spirituality at a very unlikely place. This barter market operated by Kakachin, Shokekancha and Laris communities. This is an incredible market, flush with a range of corns, potatoes, vegetables and hundreds of other gifts from the earth. But what made it spiritual for us was the mode of transaction. As we moved around the market, we saw the women completely shunning money and just exchanging the produce that they had brought with them. They had completely demonetized their system, exactly the way food crops, fruits and vegetables need to be respectfully exchanged. The very gesture of acceptance that marked these transactions was deeply moving for us. It clarified for us what the term non-monetary affluence meant. Later, we also understood that this system had led to a very rich genetic flow. Potatoes from the upper reaches and the vegetables and fruits from the lower reaches, traveling to the mid reaches to be exchanged by people from all heights of the Andes. We mentally compared this with our markets, which have not escaped the pressures of monetization. We thought, why should it be so? Is there some way we can avoid this monetization and bring back the long-lost barter economy into our markets? This was an unspoken resolve in all our minds. Another market of the craftswomen and men of Cuyo Grande. For us, this is a treat to watch. Woolen blankets, dresses, caps, shawls, woven by nimble fingers, bring alive the softest of colors and finest of motifs. As their colorful products spread before us, we are transported back to the Deccan, where our craftspeople refuse to depart from the harsh monochromes of their environment and stay austere in their choice of colors and motifs. One of the high points of our visit is this exhibition of medicinal plants put up by the potato park communities. The immense wealth of the medicinal plants presented by the communities mesmerizes us. We are in for a greater treat when we visit the Chokakancha community, where we are welcomed to the sound of bugles, kashwe dances and flowers. The sheer variety and range of the incredible exhibition of native seeds, vegetables, medicinal plants and biopesticides put up by more than 150 women involved in the Vinay Varnas group takes our breath away. In return, we also put up an exhibition of the dryland seeds of the Deccan. We open the exhibition singing our traditional songs and lighting the ritual lamp. The traditions of Deccan raise a spate of questions from our hosts.
They have traditional knowledge in the community. What kind of traditional knowledge do they have? Do you have festivals too? I would like to know what are the names of those festivals.
This was an opportunity for us to describe the string of festivals that bind us to Mother Earth, to our animals and to our crops. This sharing of information about our cultures and traditions gave way to the more serious business of the ways of documenting the traditional knowledge of indigenous communities from pre-literate societies. In DDS, we've done a lot of work in documenting people's knowledge surrounding agro-biodiversity. It was time for us to share this process with the Quechua community.
The facilitator here is someone who is right there. She has done facilitated this entire process. She cannot read and write, but she can.
We show them our films and lead the discussions.
So it starts evolving like that. Different crops, different parameters, different kinds of evaluations, and all of them are written down.
I'm going to go to the hospital. పచ్చి ఆడమ్తారు ఏం పైసలు మార్కెట్లో కలిపారమని చేసిండ్రు ఎందరి పోసారు.
Then those who can sign, they sign. Those who cannot sign, they put their fingerprint.
Aici documentul pe care tu cocoște, mai din cocoșe firmai ca atingi cu una firma cum va ne trec cu una ta, marca în cotul.
Mirandar, pudua lungi, orice tom, busoni, mandal, ma calman, ce am zis ne-am dat eu. Ma dirie stara pune, andar gina, namaskar, namaskar.
They say that this is our knowledge, we have sat together, we have done it, we have put it into a document, we want this document, we take a pledge to protect it. And you can see that the register has so many pages, so many kinds of graphs, so many kinds of parameters, and all the details are entered into it.
It was extremely important for us to underline these points, since a lot of controversy surrounds the issue of community biodiversity registers. While one school of activists opposes any documentation, a more government scientist-led group works towards making written registers by a team of scientists with very little or no participation by the community. In DDS, we have upheld the right of the communities to make their own registers by involving all members of the community, primarily women and the excluded. The discussions seamlessly merge into a workshop on the actual process of preparing the biodiversity registry. We practically demonstrate how such a registry could be done. Using wool that was abundantly available there, we soon create a matrix, and in less than an hour, the process is on.
You have hundreds of potatoes, you have hundreds of corns, you have hundreds of vegetables. We would like you to tell us which are the 5 potatoes that we should put there. Now we will have the eldest member of the group to tell us one potato.
Suggesting you, huh? Is very important.
Yes, perfect.
After our brief introduction to the process, we hand over the facilitation to one of the Cuyo Grande women. The process becomes joyously participatory and totally owned up by the group. Even as we watch in fascination, the women develop their own set of parameters and start characterizing their potatoes, corns and vegetables against these parameters.
Does this potato sell very well? Now, we saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 varieties of potatoes. Some are very good for market, some are not good for market.
What?
Okay, if this is best for market, 5, 6. So how many seeds will you give for this? This gets 5,
yeah.
So how much should this get?
3.
Okay.
So this is 1 to 4, 4.
Okay, right. So we go by this, what more people to say? If this is the best for market,
yeah.
Now what we will say is, we have seeds here.
Yeah.
In the seeds, the best one gets 5 seats.
Very soon, they understand the process of matching the axes, and the group of women start working completely on their own, sharing knowledge and taking decisions to evaluate the diversity of products included in the matrix.
¿Qué caja será esta compañera con
él?
Within a couple of hours, a grand matrix was right there in front of our eyes, rich in its content, rich in its visual texture, and rich in the knowledge that it represented. The Quechua women had produced their first non-written community biodiversity register. Within no time, they had queued up to sign this register to say that it was their shared knowledge, and together they were taking the responsibility to protect it. A major objective of the visit had been concluded with so much participation, happiness, and exchange between grassroots women from across the continents. The registry making process was quickly followed by understanding the process of making a video register and the main elements of such a register. Even as we explained the process, both the Deccan and the Quechua women busy themselves translating the words into visuals. Chinna Narasamma, one of the trustees of the Community Media Trust of the DDS, takes the floor and explains the philosophy behind and the working of the trust. The trust, she says, had enabled non-literate, marginalized women of the Deccan to become successful and creative filmmakers to articulate their community concerns. We then take part in a video festival that shows two of our films and one of the films made by the Potato Park team. We screen the films on our mobile biodiversity festival and the process of making a community biodiversity register. It was not just the video festival. Every moment we spent in the Potato Park community appeared to us as a celebratory festival where we were wonderfully happy to share our experiences, skills, and our culture. Never before had we been a part of an exchange of this nature. Never before we had seen such bonding of cultures. Never before we had been showered with such affection and friendship by people we had never known before. If such exchanges take place between peoples and cultures, our earth will be a happier and peaceful place for all of us to live. That is the way to salute Mother Earth, Pachamama.